January brings the snow, makes your feet and fingers glow. February's ice and sleet, freeze the toes right off your feet. Welcome March with wintry wine, would thou wert not so unkind. April brings the sweet spring showers, on and on for hours and hours. Farmers fear unkindly May, frost by night and hail by day. June just rains and never stops, 30 days and spoils the crops. In July the sun is hot, is it shining? No, it's not. August cold and dank and wet, brings more rain than any yet. Bleak September's mist and mud is enough to chill the blood. Then October adds a gale, wind and slush and rain and hail. Dark November brings the fog, should not do it to a dog. Freezing wet December then, bloody January again.
I hope that's been helpful to those of you planning your holidays. Another very useful travel tip, despite all you may have heard to the contrary, the rain in Spain stays almost invariably in the hills.
Oh dear, what a weather this is.
So it was very nice yesterday, wasn't it? Spring, I enjoyed that. Missed it last year, I was in the bathroom.
Well, after that we thought we ought to take you somewhere a little bit warmer,
to the tropics, for a song which we call The Reluctant Cannibal.
Seated one day at the tom-tom, I heard a welcome shout from the kitchen. Come and get it, roast leg of insurance salesman. A chorus of yums ran round the table. Yum, 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 yum. Except for Junior, who pushed away his shell, got up from his log and said,
I don't want any part of it.
What?
Why not?
I don't eat people.
Hey?
I won't eat people.
Huh?
I don't eat people.
I must be going deep.
Eating people is wrong.
It's wrong.
Don't eat people.
You've gone clean out of your mind.
I won't eat people.
What's the matter with the lad?
Don't eat people.
He keeps on repeating.
Eating people is bad.
But people have always eaten people. What else is there to eat? If the juju had meant us not to eat people, he wouldn't have made us of meat.
Don't eat people.
Oh, no, not again.
I won't eat people.
All the day long. Don't eat people, he keeps on repeating. Eating people is wrong.
Well, I never heard a more ridiculous idea in all my born days. To think that a son of mine should grow up to be a sissy. Me, chief assistant to the assistant chief. I suppose you realize, son, if this was to get around, we might never get self-government.
I won't eat people.
Have you been talking to one of your mothers again? You're not getting to be one of these cranks that thinks that eating people is cruel, are you? You're seeing a man sitting in a pot and you think he's suffering.
Oh, it's not like that at all. Why, he's just had an invigorating chase through the forest. He's sitting there in the nice warm water with all the carrots and dumplings and things. He's thinking, oh, the pleasure and happiness I'm going to give to a whole heap of people. That man in the pot there, he enjoys it.
Eating people is wrong.
Look, son, I admire your sincerity. Always be sincere, whether you mean it or not. You're young.
When you're young, you think you could change the whole world overnight, even eating people.
I know I've been young myself. Take it from your old dad. You've just got to learn to take the world as it is.
I won't let another man pass my lips.
I know why you say don't eat people, because you are a coward, Francis. That's your trouble. You're a yellow-livered coward.
You wouldn't mind eating people if you weren't afraid of ending up in the pot yourself. How despicable. Gone like this, you're liable to get me into hot water.
I won't eat people.
That's enough.
I don't eat
don't
people.
Don't want to
eat people is wrong.
Communist. Going around saying don't eat people, that's the way to make people hate you.
We always have eaten people, always will eat people.
You can't change human nature.
Well, let's try people, this thing.
It must have been someone he ate.
I give up.
He used to be a regular anthropophagi. This crazy idealistic idea of yours was to catch on. I just don't know where we would all be. Just about ruin our entire internal economy.
Fortunately, I suppose it's catching on isn't really very likely. Why, you might just as well go around saying don't fight people, for example.
Don't fight people?
Well, can you imagine? Well, you see.
All part of the same fantastical possibility.
Oh, that's the boy. Ridiculous.
Architecture, said Hegel, is frozen music, as you'll remember. Donald Swann's music has often been compared with defrosted architecture. Nowhere is this more evident than in his setting which has been described by music critics all over this country as spiffing, of this song, Design for Living. When we started making money...
When we started making friends...
We found a home as soon as we were able to. We bought this bijou residence for about 1,000 more than the house our little house was once the stable to.
With charm.
Colour values.
Wit.
And structural alteration. Now designed for graceful living. It has quite a reputation. We're terribly house and garden at number 7B. We live in a most amusing muse, ever so very contemporary. We're terribly house and garden, the money that one spends to make a place that won't disgrace our house and garden friends. We've bland and uninhibited interior decor,
curtains made of straw.
We've wallpapered the floor. We don't know if we like it, but at least we can be sure there's no place like home, sweet home. It's fearfully maison chardin at number 7B. We've rediscovered the chandelier.
Très, très, very contemporary.
We're terribly house and garden. Now at last we've got the chance.
The garden's full of furniture.
And the house is full of plants. It doesn't make for comfort, but it simply has to be.
Cos we're never so terribly up-to-date contemporary.
Have you a home that cries out your every visitor, here lives someone who is exciting to know? No? Well, why not? Collect those little metal bottle tops and nail them upside down to the floor. This will give a sensation of walking on little metal bottle tops. Turn upside down. Why not get hold of an ordinary Northumbrian spokeshaver's coracle? Paint it in contrasting stripes of, say, telephone black and white, and hang it up in the hall for a guitar tidy for parties. Why not drop in one evening for a mess of potting, our speciality, just aubergine and carnation petals, with a 6-shilling bottle of mule de pape, a feast fit for a king. I'm delirious about our new cooker fitment with the eye-level grill. This means that without my having to bend down, the hot fat can squirt straight into my eye.
We're frightfully house and garden at number 7B. The walls are patterned with shrunken heads, ever so very contemporary. Our boudoir on the open plan has been a huge success.
Now, everywhere so open, there's nowhere safe to dress. With
little screens and bottle lamps and motifs here and there. And mobiles in the air.
Ivy everywhere.
You mustn't be surprised to meet a cactus on the stair. But we call it home, sweet home.
We're terribly house and garden, as I think we said before. But those 7B is madly gay.
It wouldn't do for every day. We actually live in 7A, in the house next door.